Now, before we go on working on our project, let's just stop for a moment to reflect what is actually the thing what we're making. What is the end objective of architecture, if you want, in general? Obviously, architects create buildings and spaces, but I will argue that the final result of architecture are not the buildings, but things that people do there. That's why it's really important, if you want to create design that's relevant to people, to try to guide your design not by forms, but by sort of stories about activities and things that people do in the places you design. Now, let's illustrate this with an example. Let's consider a project by Alejandro Aravena. He's a Chilean architect, and his studio was faced with the following design task. They had to design homes for poor families on a very tight public subsidy. Now, as always, public funding is rarely enough to make for a quality social housing. And what architects usually do in this kind of situation is that architects either try to take advantage of that money to create a good quality home, but then these homes need to be very small, or they try to make a normal size homes, but then the quality has to suffer. What Aravena said, and also with talking with residents, they came to the conclusion that they really want to have both quality and the normal size of homes, because anything else would result in bad living conditions, and these sort of bad living conditions always, let's say, perpetuate poverty. The solution that Aravena came while talking to residents is that instead of trying to make a small home, they will try to make one half of a really good quality home, and then they will leave space and infrastructure so that the resident can fill in and create the second half of the home when they're able to do that. Now, in this kind of solution, we can see that Aravena wasn't thinking about what is the kind of building that I can make with this money. Instead, Aravena reframed the problem to think about what is the process that can lead these people to better life. In other words, Aravena formulated his design objective as a story. And as I said, this is the best way to really always have a human perspective in mind and always to remember that you are actually designing something for people and you're not designing forms in space. So, really good way to think about your design, because often as architects, what we get at the design brief are numbers. So we get asked to build 150 apartments or build office for 2,000 people, but these numbers don't tell us anything about people behind them and what their real motivations should be. So as an architect, it would really be good to try to transform these numbers into a story. And as a matter of fact, first try to think about what kind of people are you designing for. So as always, try to empathize, and then start writing your story from the end. Try to imagine a happy ending and write it down, and then keep writing back so that you can see the process, as I said, that leads these people that you design for to desire a happy ending. Now, maybe this sounds very theoretical to you, but you will see in the next couple of videos how you can apply this principle for your design project.